I wanted to work with Alexander Hamel for years, and I was calling him, inviting him, begging him, you know, all the things, but he was always busy with his books. And I asked once, and I got lucky that he said, I just finished my book and I would like to, you know, shift to something else, experience something else, and he said, let's try it. And we had two ideas, but very quickly we decided, okay, let's go for something which will be joy, which will be fun for people to watch, because we think politically it's important to have alternative to this media pressure and beliefs in Bosnia that life is fucked up. Okay, it is hard and so on, but it's important also to be allowed, to allow yourself to be happy, to say, yes, every day of this life, and we have only one life, is going to, we are going to enjoy it. And for me, that is not, you know, entertainment in a sense of escaping the reality, but accepting that part of yourself and life around you is also full of love and joy. So that's our first intention. I knew from beginning I want to do something on an island about tourists, and that main issue is family and challenges that family has. So we didn't know where the story will go. We just had this family, and it was developing through the process. I think he was open for that, which is great. And he was, of course, laughing about differences. And when also process of filmmaking started, he would sometimes say, I would go crazy, you know, with so many people. Because film is like, on one hand, like a crazy excursion trip, school trip of full of teenagers with a lot of adrenaline. But on the other hand, it's like a military structure. So these two opposite things had to fit together perfectly. So I think Hammond, I mean, this is more question for him, but I think he was open and eager to see new stuff, to learn, to, you know, just because I think, and he told me that once, that he wanted to, very long time ago when he was a teenager, he wanted to be a film director. And when I was a teenager, I wanted to be a writer. So I think our secret talents met. It was really, I was very nervous, because Sarajevo audience is hard, especially when it comes to laughing matter about this issue. I was nervous how people will, would they accept the film and how would they react? And I really enjoyed it, because I had feeling it was such a good energy in the cinema. And when Bosnians who homophobic, let's say, when they were applauding for two women kissing and two men kissing, I was happy, because I have feeling we gained something. Yeah, for me, because I feel as part of this society, the most important thing is to make a story which will move society forward in thinking. Of course, I'm not naive to think I will change society by films, but if one person in the audience is changed by the film, I'm totally happy. So I always start with the idea of how this talks about my society, hoping that I'm making also universal story, because film would be too expensive to make it only for such a small market. But I think what we were missing as Bosnians is, how should I say it? Love is something that is missing here. Obviously, after the war, nobody's talking about love. There is a lot of manipulation and a lot of hate speeches. And in media, you can read every day, even if you are not a person who hates, it gets into you, this bad energy. And Hemon and I wanted to make something which will bring people good energy, that they not forget love. And not in this naive sense, but really in this feeling like, yes, we can love somebody who is different, and we could accept more people to love. We don't have to love our own nation, our own wives. We could expand. These kind of touristic resorts, they are always, the part of routine is to have music at these dinners and entertainment at night. So we knew it's a part of logic of portraying this resort. And then we started thinking, okay, this guy who is very extrovert and very full of himself will of course sing. And then it got into more, when we started searching for songs, we understood, okay, we are using music also as a dialogue, because what people are singing, they are also communicating. These words are important for them. So Alexander and Lee DeLong, our collaborator, also wrote a text which is specifically for the scene. Instead of dialogue, the characters are singing. And I had wonderful composer Balz Bachmann from Switzerland, living in Berlin. And this collaboration was also great, because I would explain what I want and he would do it. We would try it, redo it, and that's how it went. Look, I grew up with this festival. I was a student when the festival started. I worked all kinds of jobs, you know, as a hospitality, in press. Then I did my own program once. So I know festival from inside, and I feel, though I'm not working at a festival, as a part of it. It's like my hand. And I love how it developed, and I really congratulate Miro, Izeta and team on how big it is, how important it is for the city. It's now one of the key moments of the city, but it also shows, when you have a vision, how you can make things possible even in a country which in everyday life show us nothing is possible. So this is really inspiration for people working in a film. And as a filmmaker, I love to see wonderful movies that are here from the region, from the world, and to meet people, you know. It's fun, like last night we had a party and Garcia Bernal was at our party. So it's like really such a great international event.